Hey guys, Railroad Sniper here today with another video. So it's kind of a more of a PSA type video. I mean, it's kind of obvious, but be careful around these things. It wasn't with this exact blade, but over the summer I switched over to these DeWalt carbide blades. Pretty sharp at first, honestly, but they don't. Excuse me. They do dull down really quickly. Especially, not like, even compared to regular steel blades. And one of the reasons, gosh, don't want to focus. One of the reasons I believe that is because, if you can see it glinting in the light, that very edge, that edge is pretty fine compared to that broad edge right there. See? And it gets chipped very easily because carbon is so hard. So it cuts really well at first. And it might cut, might stay at a duller level longer. But if you're cutting stuff like plastic or paper, like just in thin air, you know, it's not going to do the best. So after those run out, I'm going to try these out. Craftsman Heavy Duty Induction Hardened Blades. I'm hoping that they'll be similar to the Stanley Made in USA heavy duty blades. Same company, you know, so hopefully they'll be similar for a cheaper price. But anyway, another thing I would say is to replace these blades before they get too dull, because dull blade can sometimes be more dangerous than a regular blade than a sharp one. Case in point, trigger warning, you know, if you don't like scars or whatever, but I did cut myself this summer. It wasn't over the summer. It was like actually last semester. That's why I stopped making videos for a little bit. Basically what happened is I was working on my bike and zip tying some of the cables in place. And I was cutting some of the zip ties and I didn't have any flush cutters on me. I should have just gone and grabbed them. But in my haste, pulled this thing out. I was cutting them towards me. I was like, it's being really difficult to cut. And all of a sudden it cut. And knife went straight into my arm. Luckily, it missed everything. I'm all good, you know. Got all the dexterity back, luckily. Still not full strength, but at least I'm not disabled, you know. That's a big thing. But yeah, ever since then, always cut away from yourself. Especially if it's something really difficult that cuts through suddenly. That's for sure. Or if this just might not be the right tool for the job, you know. Just grab some diagonal cutters, some flush cutters, like any kind of cutting pliers. Something that will not suddenly fling towards someone. I guess after that, now that that's out of the way, this utility knife is still doing really well. Unlike my flashlight. So far the G32's been doing pretty well. I do like that it's more modular. I'll show you. So once you've got it in this position, you can actually screw off this top bit. And that reveals an O-ring to keep the water out. And this part's just the lens assembly that screws on. That might be replaceable, I'm not sure. But the real cool thing is that if something ever happened, like on my old flashlight where the LED went out, I believe this is actually replaceable. As you can see, there's two little Phillips screws in there that hold that assembly in place. So if that light ever goes out, you could probably replace it. I don't know how involved that would be, but maybe that could be something in the future if this one goes bad. Anyway. So, yeah, that's just kind of where I'm at right now. One downside, I would say, about this knife so far that I see as a potential failure in the future. If this will focus. Gosh. Okay, there we go. This rivet is a little loose. As you can see, it moves. Let me see if I can show you on this side. That rivet moves. And this thing does not sit flush anymore. See, it's sticking up. And also sticks up in the fully closed position. If fact, let me see if I can show you that again. Yeah, so I see that rivet being a potential failure in the future. Just one flaw of this. Otherwise, I really love it. But, yeah, anyway, this was more of a channel update video slash tool update video slash warning. So, anyways, maybe an actual tool review in the future. And I'll see you guys in the next one.